A prenuptial agreement is a contract signed by two people preparing to marry that outlines how their assets will be divided if they divorce. In Michigan, this is also known as an antenuptial agreement. In this video, we'll cover prenuptial agreements, including what a prenup is, what Michigan law has to say about these agreements, and how to make sure yours holds up in a Michigan court. Prenups are increasingly becoming a common part of a couple's financial planning process, especially if one or both partners has great wealth, a lot of debt, or children from a previous partnership. Discussing a prenup can be a good way for spouses to be to make sure that they're on the same page about their financial future. Make sure to watch to the end of this video so you can download a fillable prenup and see for yourself how easy it can be to get the process started. But before we talk about what the document looks like, let's talk about what Michigan law has to say about prenups. Most states in the US have adopted the Uniform Premarital Agreement Act, which was passed in 1983 to make prenup laws consistent across courts. Michigan has not adopted this law. Instead, Michigan has its own statutes, one that says that a contract relating to property signed before marriage is still valid after marriage. In other words, prenups are enforceable. Another statute says a prenup can't cover any issues related to the custody or care of children, even if both spouses have an agreement about how they will support their kids after a divorce. The court reserves the right to make the final decisions about minors. The logic is that the court has a responsibility to protect the rights of children. In Michigan, the courts have the authority to make sure a divorce ends equitably. Judges consider the length of the marriage, the ages and health and financial situations of both parties, and other factors before deciding on how to divide assets and responsibilities between spouses. A decision handed down in 2017 shows the court's power to supersede a prenup. In that decision, the court said it had the authority to award one spouse's separate property, property not acquired during the marriage, to the other party in the divorce, even though that the prenup protected separate property. The takeaway is that a prenup can't take precedent over the court's judgment. The good news is there are some things you can do to make sure that your prenup is fair, which makes it much more likely to hold up in a Michigan court. First, you and your spouse-to-be should strongly consider getting separate and independent legal advice. Each of you should also consult your own lawyer. You should make a list of your assets, debts, incomes, and financial obligations before you visit an attorney. This can take some time to think through, so it's a good idea to start planning for this months before your wedding. This point leads us to the second way you can make sure that your prenup will hold up in court. Sign it early. If you sign it on the week of your wedding, a judge could later conclude that one of you was pressured into it or that both of you didn't have time to consider the consequences. Once you've consulted with your lawyers and decided on the terms of your prenup, the agreement must be signed by the party with more to lose. It's recommended that the signing happens in front of a notary public. It's also a good idea to include the names and signatures of the lawyers representing both parties on the document itself. Until several decades ago, Michigan courts wouldn't even entertain a prenup. No American courts would have. This kind of contract was believed to encourage divorce, but divorce is happening anyway. And many couples will tell you that they're glad that they thought about a prenup before they tied the knot. To see what a prenup looks like, click the link right here. Hit that subscribe button as well for more videos that can help you save a lot of time, energy, and money in some of life's most stressful moments.